Today I'm gonna remix the new Swedish House Mafia and The Weeknd song. Yo, what's up guys, welcome to a new video. My name is Warcro, and you know that sometimes I like to challenge myself, to try new things, to make songs in these videos, and today I thought to make a new remix of the new Swedish House Mafia and The Weeknd song called Moth to a Flame. Because basically, I like a lot this song, but I think the drop is not really a drop for the dance floor, it's more for the radios, you know, it's more pop style. So, why not trying to make it more electronic? So nothing else, remember to subscribe and let's get to it. So here we have the song at the right BPM, 120, and if you didn't listen to it, just let me play it. But does he know you call me when he sleeps? So it's nice, but it's a bit too slow, you know, and not really electronic. So the first thing I'm gonna do is put it on 126 or 28. But as you can see, it doesn't stretch, and yeah, then you can just fit it to a tempo. So, but what I'm gonna do is go to tools, macros, switch all the clips to real-time stretching. And right now, if I put it to 126 or 28, it doesn't matter, it stays in the grid. If you watch my YouTube shorts, you already know this trick. And well, basically what I'm gonna do is just switch the drop, so. But the first thing I'm gonna do is try to get the chords of this song, so I stay in the same key and the same chords and all these things. To know the chords of the song, I'm gonna put here this pattern, and where I have just the key, that is C minor, and just the piano. I'm also gonna put this filter in the master, so this way I only hear the bass, and it's easier to match the notes of my piano with the notes of the bass. So basically what I'm gonna do is just put here some notes, and let's see which one are fitting with the notes of the original song. If it doesn't fit, you're gonna know it really easy, because it's gonna sound so weird. For example, if we put it here, it doesn't fit. This is one. So now we have the bass notes, just like this. All right, so let's listen without a filter. And this way, we have our remix. Thank you so much for watching this video. And now I mirrored the bass notes, because what I want to know is the melody that he has. Those notes. Alright, so now we have the bass line and the melody. And right now I'm gonna put some synth for the bass line, some synth for the leads and all of this. And to do it faster, I'm just gonna use Project Bones of other songs. So these are the Project Bones of Can't Shake You, and just throw here the bass line, and boom, I have all the bass synth.
A few moments later.
So I just put here the notes of the bass line. Sounds perfect. This is probably too low. Yeah, I'm gonna put one octave higher. Let's put here the melody for the leads. Too high. And for the chords, I don't know perfectly the notes, I'm gonna just create my own chords, so just do something like this. Yeah, sorry for the CPU, you know, recording and doing this. It's a bit difficult. Now let's get some drums. For the kick, I'm gonna go to my sample pack, and I think I have a kick in C. Yeah, this one. And I found these drums, and now it's like this. But you know, I think I'm not gonna use the original song. I just want the vocal. So let me try to find the cappella on internet. All right, so I found it. It's not the best one, but with the synth and everything, you're not gonna hear those problems. You see? It's good. And I think I'm gonna add some arps and other kind of chord sounds. So for the arp, I'm just gonna do something like this. Perfect. And for the voice, I think I'm just gonna put one note, like the bass. And maybe duplicate it one octave higher. And this is how it sounds so far. You know, what I'm gonna do is delete the chords here, just leave it like this, and here the second part we're gonna have the chords, so it's gonna give more ambience and emotional feeling. And also what I'm gonna do is make these voices unique. So this way here, what I'm gonna do is put the chords in the entire voices. And this is also gonna help a lot to give a lot more emotion and energy to the second part of the drop. Oh, but I'm missing something, because I'm stupid, and it's this brass bass.
But I'm also still missing some warmth on the drop, and what I think I'm gonna do is, if we listen to the original song, it has some kind of pad sound for the chords in the drop, or at least chords really warm. So what I'm gonna do is just put the pad on the drop. And for the pad, I'm just gonna go to my sound bank, where I have a lot of sounds, as you can see. If you want my sound bank, just down below in the description, you have it, you know, and you have 80 presets for all the genres and everything, you know, basses, chords, slits, blah, blah, blah. So let's see which one works. This is the one I was looking for. So if we put it here, all these three things are going to give a lot of ambience to it. Now, of course, we need some effects. So far we have this. Okay, it sounds pretty good. Let me put here on the original song, like Endless Smile, and reduce the volume and so. So this way, when the drop comes, it feels stronger and louder and all these things. Okay, and as you can see the original song, here already starts the melody, this point. So let me put here also this last note, and it feels like the notes, it's not only one, it feels like it's like two every time. So it feels like this. Yeah, but not that much. Maybe it's like shorter. Does he know you? You know, here would be nice something like di-di-di-di, you know, some kind of effect like this, but I don't know what effect I have like this, so I'm just gonna do it myself. And for this, I'm gonna go again to my sound bank, and I'm just gonna use probably this plug. And I want something maybe like no rectifier. Let's see. So like, love it. Yeah, let me finish this. Let me finish the mixdown, you know, to mix it a bit better. But the thing is gonna be it, you know, like I have all the elements I want. Let me finish, and for you it's gonna be just a second, and for me it's gonna be maybe like 20 minutes, but let's see.
20 minutes later.
So guys, the song is mixed, and actually I like it a lot, you know. I think it's one of the best songs I've made here on YouTube, at least in my opinion, or at least right now. Maybe I listen tomorrow and it sounds like shit. Let me know in the comments if you think I should finish this and release it for free, and you know, as a bootleg remix, or however you want to call it. But well, let's see the end result. But don't forget to subscribe and like this video, because it took a lot of time to finish this. He seems like he's good for you, and he makes you feel like you should. And all your friends say he's the one. His love for you is true. But does he know?